first topic of consideration is the various factors affecting the channel selection, which is a very important topic by itself. There are various five kind of considerations which actually affect the channel selection, being market consideration, product consideration, company consideration, middleman consideration, and marketing environment consideration. The first one, let's look into further detail, that is the market consideration. Here, the factors are, first one, nature of the market. Whether we are dealing with the consumer market or the business market plays a very important role in determining the channel selection. If we are dealing with the consumer market, middlemen such as retailers and wholesalers become very important. However, if it's a B2B, that is a business to business market, then the middlemen can be curtailed and we can directly reach out to the end users. The second consideration is the number of potential customers. If the customers whom we want to reach out, that is our target customers, are in huge number, then the middlemen are required and their services can play a very important role in targeting and reaching the potential customers. However, if the size of the potential customers is very small, the middlemen services can be ignored or may not be required. The third is geographical concentration of the market, meaning if our target customers are very widely distributed and situated in different geographical locations, the role and the play of the marketing middlemen becomes very important. However, if the consumers or the target customers are very sparsely populated and very closely located to each other, the producer or the seller may choose to reach out to the consumers themselves, ignoring the middlemen. Next being the sales volume. That is, if we are targeting at achieving very high volume of sales, then the middlemen services becomes inevitable. However, if we are looking at a class marketing and very smaller levels of customers and niche people, then the middlemen can be ignored and the producer can directly get in touch with the consumers by probably opening their own stores or by personal selling. The next being consumer buying habit. By this we mean the size and the average frequency of the customers' orders. If the size and the frequency of customers' orders are huge and large in number, the marketing middlemen services are definitely required, and vice versa. The second point in consideration is the product consideration. Having said that, under that, the first one is the unit sale value of the product. If the per unit value of the product is very high, then the middlemen services can be avoided. The producer would want to get in touch directly with the consumer because of the very high value of the product. Second being the bulk and the weight. With regards to bulky and highly heavy kind of materials and goods, the producer might yet again want to reduce the transportation and the storage and reduce the handling of the goods by middlemen and directly want to reach or with just one level of channel reached out to the consumers. Whereas goods which are of perishable nature, that is the ones which do not have a very long lifeline and are not durable, yet again cannot be used with too many middlemen in between. The goods being of non-durable nature have to be directly reached out to the customers or maximum with just one level of middlemen in between. The next being price stability. If the good or the service which we are talking about into consideration has stabilized prices over a period of time, that is, the prices for which do not change with small changes in the environment or in the economy, over there the middlemen can come into play. Whereas if the product or the service under consideration is tend to achieving or being subjected to a lot of price fluctuation, then middlemen services have to be ignored. And the last point here for the product consideration is standardization. If the goods are of standardized nature and uniform in quality, middlemen services can easily be utilized. However, if the goods can vary in different lots, the middlemen services tend to be ignored and not used. The third point into consideration is the company consideration. That is, with regards to it, the first one is the size of the firm. If it is a very big firm and a very huge firm, they can tend to avoid the middlemen services and do all the middlemen functions by themselves. Next, financial strength. If the company has huge amount of financial resources in its disposal, it can themselves perform the marketing middleman functions and not go for the professional ones. However, if a company is low on financial strength, instead of actually getting into this entire area of middleman marketing, they have to hire the professionals because that becomes way cheaper for the company. The next being duration of operation of the firm. If the firm is a very established, well-reputed and long-term operating firm, that is the one which is already known in the market, has a good brand name in the market, can avoid the marketing middleman services. They can directly reach out to the customers because the customers are already aware about the operation and the duration of the firm. However, if it is a fairly new firm into the market, they have to use the middleman specialized services to reach out to the consumers. The next point being the reputation of the firm, which is the brand name of the firm. If the brand is a well-established one in the market and a very well-reputed one, the middleman services may not play very handy and useful over here. However, if it is a newer brand which is not well established and has a lot of competition, the middlemen's specialized promotional activities and services can play very handy over here. And the last factor here being market control. If the firm wants to have the control of the market to himself or control and share the market's entire role by themselves, they have to perform the middleman services by themselves. However, if the company is more interested in just the goods being sold and does not really care about controlling the market share, can easily use the middleman services. The next point being the marketing environment. By this we mean whether the environment is experiencing a recession period or a prosperity period. During recession period, obviously the entire economy is going through a downfall and it is a very tough time. At this time, companies avoid to use the middleman services because of cost cutting and still maintaining the profits level. However, if it is a prosperity situation, companies definitely want to go to use the middleman services, indulge in various kind of promotional and extra activities so as to reach out much better and in a proper way to the customers. And the last consideration being the competitors consideration. Here what we mean is that the kind of channels which our competitors or the substitute products are using also plays a very important role in determining the choice of selection by us. That is, two different ways can be used here. Firstly, companies can try to ignore the channels which are actually used by competitors so as to create a separate niche or a competitive advantage for themselves. Or they actually will research and use much more aggressive techniques and use the same channels which are selected by the competitors to reach out to the target customers in a much better way.